It's coming up to 20 to 12. Now, our local theatres and arts venues are counting the days until they can reopen again. But until then, obviously they're desperate to keep on fundraising in a bid to keep going during the pandemic. Well, South Hill Park in Bracknell has been championed by the likes of Sir Kenneth Branagh, and now a children's book based on the venue is hoping to make a real difference as far as they're concerned. Let's have a word with author Jane Howard. Right then, so you've got this book, which is called The Beast of South Hill Park, which you have written. And I think, is it your mum that's illustrated it?
It is, yes. It's a family collaboration.
Is there a family connection with South Hill Park to begin with?
Well, only really that I grew up there. So we lived in Bracknell. My parents are still there.
Yeah.
And we just enjoyed having it on our doorstep as residents in Bracknell. And then I worked there in my 20s as well.
Right. Okay. Yeah. I mean, I'd say that's some attachment that you've got to that place. It is a lovely venue, and it's very unique, isn't it, to our area as well. We're very lucky to have it. So what brought about the idea for the book then? Where did that start?
Well, I've always fancied doing a picture book, especially when I could see the artwork that my mum was producing from the art classes there. I've always done a bit of creative writing as well. And it seemed like an obvious project that we could do together. So during lockdown, we had a bit more time on our hands. And I don't live in Bracknell at the moment, but it was a nice creative thing to do together across the miles. Something interesting to talk about over Zoom. And I just plotted out a basic story and she drew and painted the pictures.
Okay, so did you do all of this on Zoom? So you sort of told her where to put the pictures, she did the pictures, and then presumably she showed you the pictures and you gave her a thumbs up or a thumbs down on Zoom?
Well, no, a lot of it was kind of emails. And then when sort of July came around, we were in the back garden as well, obviously 2 metres apart.
Obviously, but, yes.
Yeah, yeah. It was, phone calls, all sorts of things, really.
So what led you to decide on the storyline? So you knew that you wanted to write a children's book about South Hill Park, but that's all you knew. So talk to us about the storyline, the premise of the book and how you came up with it.
I wanted to do something that showcased what happens in all of the different spaces in the venue. You know, it's a theatre, it's a cinema, a comedy venue, there's gigs, there's festivals. So it was really a way of showcasing all of the different rooms and the activities that take place there. But then making it appealing for children as well. So creating this kind of a little bit scary, but kind of a quite amusing character that's potentially lurking somewhere in the building. We've got our central character, the explorer, that's travelling around the different rooms, and he keeps mistaking innocent things for this monster. For instance, he hears this kind of screeching, scratching noise that he thinks is monster claws. He goes in and it's just a broken string from some quartet of musicians playing.
Okay. So, I mean, the building itself, anyone who's ever been to South Hill Park will know that it's a building that lends itself well to something lurking within its four walls, because it's got that kind of, just got that feel about it, hasn't it?
Yes, it's got a lot of character, you know, sort of a lot of history there. So it does sort of set your imagination on fire when you're walking around. It's a very unique place.
So what kind of age range is this book aimed at then?
It's 5 to 8 years old.
Okay.
But to be honest, I think anyone that knows the venue will enjoy looking at the pictures, because my mum has captured some very recognisable qualities about the building.
Well, that's what I was going to say, because you could have gone one of two ways with the illustrations for it. You could either have done fairly generic illustrations that weren't based on the authentic South Hill Park, or you could have gone in the opposite direction where you can really tell that it's South Hill Park. And it sounds like she's done the latter then.
Yes, yeah, I think it was quite important. You know, the venue is the key thing in this book, really. So she felt it was very important to capture the details from all of the different rooms and the wildlife surrounding, the park around the mansion as well.
It sounds like a lovely project to have been involved in, especially bearing in mind you've been able to work on it with your mum. So all of the profits from the sale of this book go back to South Hill Park, do they?
Yes, that's right. Yes, it's available for sale on Amazon, The Beast of South Hill Park. And yes, all of the profits from sales will go to the fundraising campaign. They've got a 1,000 stars campaign as well, where you can, if you didn't want to buy a picture book, you can donate a monthly amount to South Hill Park on their website. But yeah, but sales of this book will also go to that campaign as well.
Good stuff. Sounds like a lovely project. Best of luck with it as well. That is Jane Howard, the author of this new book, The Beast of South Hill Park, which is available now. It's just gone 11:45. Here's Shania Twain now. It's BBC Radio Berkshire.
Let's go, girls.